You've probably heard about the James Gang, the Dalton Brothers Gang, and a lot of other gangs that ruled western towns at one time or another. Well, out here where the West begins, Fort Worth, Texas, the gang most talked about is the 7th Street Gang. In its heyday, the late 30s and early 40s, the gang was headed by oil man and newspaper publisher Amon Carter Sr. The gang in those days hid behind the title of the Good Government League, and its slate of candidates ruled Fort Worth off and on until the early 60s. Carter was the behind-the-scenes man who gave orders to a main man. It was defeated a couple of times by the infighting among its leaders, and once by another gang calling itself the People's Progressive League. Most Fort Worth leaders today say there is no such thing as a 7th Street Gang. They say it is only a myth. Let's just take a look at 7th Street. First, there's the First National Bank, then the Fort Worth Star-Telegram, the Fort Worth Club, and they say if you have to ask how much it costs to join this club, you automatically disqualify yourself from membership. Across the street is the Petroleum Club. Further down is the Continental National Bank. And then, the Texas Electric Service Company. The Fort Worth National Bank used to be here, but it moved last year. However, the acknowledged leader of 7th Street, H.B. Babe Fuquay, resides in this bank, and the bank's president is former Mayor Baird Freeman. And although the Fort Worth National is a couple of blocks away now, it still casts a giant shadow, or should we say reflection, on 7th Street. But it's not the buildings on 7th Street that are powerful, it's the people in those buildings. And those people will have a definite influence on the outcome of any city election.
So regardless of what anyone says, there is a 7th Street Gang. And you'd better believe it's a bad mother...